Hello everyone, I wish you a warm welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We are on the way to discover how to play KonoSuba Fantastic Days on your PC. Now you are able to watch it on your screen. We will be able to simply download and install KonoSuba Fantastic Days and play this game on a Windows desktop or laptop using our keyboard, mouse and large monitor. Then it's time to have fun, let's go! First of all mates, the first thing to do is to launch our main web browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's go to this URL that I have highlighted in green color. Now, you are able to see on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type the URL, because I provided the link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We landed right here on the site of Usitility, at which we include a detailed information on how you can download KonoSuba Fantastic Days on PC. We scroll down a little bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on the link, we reach the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to that game KonoSuba Fantastic Days on PC. It is now obvious that we have a great deal of advantages of preferring using this emulator. Now we will proceed to download the KonoSuba Fantastic Days by simply clicking on this button play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. We then click on it, and the download action starts and ends immediately. Voila, here is located the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to launch the executable file, so we click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the laptop or device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the browser to view the installation software considerably better. The installer is very simple. It includes a couple of possibilities: install and setup path. I will explain what setup path truly does. We basically click on it, and we observe that we have now here the path where the emulator can be placed. If we want to vary this directory, we must click on the Browse button, so we choose another folder and install the emulator where we wish. To keep it simple, just keep it where it is. Then, I click on Back. And I simply click on Install. Now, there it is. The installation begins and it is going to progress in the download of these MB that are displayed on the screen. The moment you save it on your hard drive, it is likely to be a little more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed could go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, subject to your internet and according to the speed capacity of the emulator hosting servers. Immediately they are working very fast. The download is completed, and so at this time it continues on with the setup procedure. The installation is going to take more or less time depending on the power of your PC. The more efficient it is, the faster the setup time and vice versa. If we join the download and install step, it normally takes a very long time, so be patient. It is by now completely finished for me. Now, the emulator has been launched successfully. As you can see, down here, there's a progress bar which will fill up then when it reaches the finish, the emulator is going to be launched for the first time. In fact, the emulator was already launched, there for the very first time. Before we continue, as you can observe, it made a couple of app icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be the one we are interested in. Anytime we want to start KonoSuba Fantastic Days on our PC, we double-click this specific app icon and consequently launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon is not about multiplayer or even nearly anything like that. The reality is, it is an icon that we will probably never ever use. Let's perform the following step, which is actually a must-have, and this is to access the Google Play Store. As you can see, the Google Play is launched. Right here we are required to log on. Now as soon as we are on this page, we must absolutely conduct the following step, which is mandatory. So we click on Sign In. Now it says, Checking Info. It may once in a while get stopped at Checking Info, additionally it does not advance. If so, you could try to connect to your account after a number of hours and it will surely probably be solved. Now we will insert our email and password. The email address must be a Gmail email address and its corresponding password. For example, you can use the very same email you're using at the moment in your YouTube account. Thus, I am going to type my details and I'll come back after I have completed it. That's it, details inserted. Discover Google welcoming us and presenting us their terms of service. We should agree to them by clicking on, I agree. Next, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also keep it selected and it will build a backup of the data on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you can make use of this option if you prefer. We click on accept. Google Play is launched automatically and completely on its own. To set up the video game, we need to browse the emulator desktop by clicking on this icon indicated in green. Now that we are watching the desktop of this emulator for Android, we can see that we have now here the install application button. We click on the button. Here we get the video game. Let's mouse click now on the install button that I am just displaying now in green. And it will begin the setup. Straight away it is going to install the game app. It usually takes a while or it may be amazingly quickly. It all is subject to on the internet connection. It's as of now completed setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by hitting this particular option I'm emphasizing in green, in order to start KonoSuba Fantastic Days for the first time. Let's mouse click on that My Games choice just above. We are by now on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are on the way to simply click this brand new KonoSuba Fantastic Days icon that has been created. The video game is launched for the very first time. Here we end up with it. I can press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will comment on the volume level of that emulator. This is right here. We have the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This way we will not depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of the emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the max, we will activate the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This is the first one. We then click on that app icon that I'm mentioning in green. And the screen is maximized, coming with one border on top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. If we really want to have fun with the application using all the screen, we click this game icon. And we would at present be experiencing and enjoying the gameplay in 100% screen mode. To quit the full screen mode, press the F11 key. And we might at present play in standard display screen mode. Now I am starting to demonstrate to you the computer keys mapping and that is definitely very enjoyable. This way we will be able to operate the game far more easily. The first point is to click this app icon. And there you will be able to get the recommended setups. I most certainly will leave the standard configuration, but if you want to change this, you can do so with no problem. As you can see, the emulator is totally in our language. Once in a while it occurs that your emulator is launched in the improper language, as an example, in Chinese. And to set it in the correct language we click here to the cogwheel. And here inside of many other configuration settings, we click the language drop down. We can select the language we like, English, Chinese, etc. After the language is chosen, we are going to save, the emulator would restart, along with the game app, next time we use it, will also be in the specified language. Now, there's another element that we have to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive an email indicating that a new device has been connected to this Google account. It will check with us if we are the ones who have connected that device. Absolutely, we may not get worried, since the emulator is acting as an Google Android tablet or smartphone. And to discover which electronic device is currently being emulated, we come back right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. And we go here to the model choice. And now we realize that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for that video user demo. I hope that you appreciated it, especially that everyone found it useful. If so, give it a superb like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your comments, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment area down below. You may also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I conduct live streams occasionally, you have it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click any of these video tutorials which are usually appearing on the suggestion of videos to watch and see you in the upcoming online videos. Bye.